Hey guys, it's Dukon Red One, and welcome to our next Westeros Craft walkthrough. We are going to be looking through Cider Hall. It is ruled by House Fossoway. Their banner is a red apple over a field of gold. And the idea is that their whole theme is that they are about apples. That's, you know, Cider Hall. It just sort of represents apple cider and everything. One thing I want to tell you guys is today we were supposed to be joined by Victor Comics, who is going to help or just walk through and be a little bit of company on our lonely walk through. But we're going to be doing this alone today, and I think that you guys will be able to draw some inspiration from this, because I for sure have been able to draw a lot of inspiration. So the idea is this castle is set on the fork between the Mander and the Cockleswint rivers. The Cockleswint is actually the river this is on. This leads down to the Red Mountains that are up against Dorne, between Dorne and the Reach and the Crownlands, I think, or the Stormlands. And then the Mander leads all the way out to the sea and leads straight up to King's Landing. And so it's a fairly popular river. It's something that's very well known. And as you can tell, we are in the Reach, which means that this whole land is ruled by House Tyrell. And Cider Hall, aka House Fossoway, is a major banner lord to the Tyrells. Also, if you guys haven't connected the dots yet, last video we did a walkthrough of New Barrel, which is actually the split family of the Fossoways. And the New Barrel is in some direction. I'm not even sure which direction it is, but anyways, New Barrel is the split family of this castle, Cider Hall. So if you guys want to watch that video, go ahead and check that out. And if you want to read on the lore, you can go ahead and check that out. I'm not going to get into names and all that stuff. That would be too confusing. So this right here is the town just outside of Cider Hall. It's really, really neat. I really like the designs and how it's laid out and such. There's a lot of really cool things to see. So we're coming now into the central town square, more or less, and in the center is a massive apple tree. Now, simply due to lore, there's really no lore on this per se, but simply due to that Cider Hall is based around apples, I guess the builders were just like, you know what, apples, let's have a giant apple tree in the middle. Like, maybe this has some sort of magic properties, like maybe it was magically grown, or maybe that it was planted with some sort of fertilizer with a weirwood. Maybe it's a cross. I don't know. Just something interesting like that. You know, just kind of try to fill in the blanks. But it sets the tone for in the courtyard right here. Really cool designs and ideas that are being implemented. Like this broken cart right here. It's a really cool idea. And then we got the several little market areas around, which I really like. And then this right here is the place for the Herald. Hey there. What's up?
Sweetheart,
uh-huh.
You look like you're starving, young boy. Have you eaten today?
I guess.
Come on in, please. Come on in.
Okay.
Come on in.
All right. This happened. What's up?
Come on in, young boy. Please sit down. Please sit down.
Should I sit over here?
Over here. Sit down. Okay. You have to eat. You have to eat now. Yep. We have pumpkin pie today.
Don't want to get too fat, but
please take some pumpkin pie.
Not too much time.
Anyways, you look like my husband in the good old days, you know. We lived here together for 30 years.
Oh, really?
How do you like the cake? I made it
delicious.
Yesterday, you know, but it didn't turn out that good, so I just thought I could give it away for free.
Okay. Very nice.
By the way,
have
you seen my young boy, Todd? He's been gone for like 9 years already. Oh, and my back makes problems again. And I have bunions on my feet that are the size of eggs. Can you believe that?
Oh, what? Where am I? Why am I in a bed? What was in those cakes I ate yesterday? What? Why does it smell like old feet in here? Oh, nasty. Oh, I gotta get out of here. Nasty, nasty, nasty. So I'm sorry about that, guys. It looks like Granny's not here. Maybe she's out shopping or something. Let's just sneak out while we can. I don't know how that happened, but anyways, that's Granny Smith's Bakery. That'll be very memorable for the future. But anyways, so that is that. So we're gonna continue our regularly scheduled programming and see what else there is to see. There is a tavern right here, it seems. This is where the men and women of the village would socialize, I guess, and they would have a few drinks and sit back and relax and do their thing. I think it actually might also be an inn. We have a privy right here. This is where they would do their thing, of course. I'm sure you guys know exactly what that is. We aren't going to go upstairs. I'm sure there's some rooms up there where people can sleep and all. So, we got some gardens in here. And then we're going to go into the sept. If you guys are not sure what a sept is, in the Westeros craft, or not the Westeros craft, in the Game of Thrones lore, there are seven gods as the main deities of the kingdoms. The old gods are the old gods, of course, and they are represented through the god trees. The children of the forest carve like the faces in them and all that stuff, but the idea is that the new faith is centered around the seven here. I know a few of them. The Stranger, I know that's the Crone. I think that's the Father, the Mother, the Maiden, the Warrior, and this one's escaping me. Not sure what that one is, but so we have the Seven in here, a little bell or some kind of little tinsels or things like that hanging from the roof up there, the ceiling. And we have a little cemetery over here with a little mausoleum. Really cool designs. I always love looking through Westeros craft and seeing all the crazy things that they have. But yeah, let's keep doing a little bit of walkthrough, do a little bit of jumping and seeing what there is to see. I really wanted to show you some of the surroundings around the village. Like you'll notice that each of the houses, well, at least most of the houses have their own little gardens and little side gardens, because each place needs to support themselves more or less with their own food. Of course, there is a ton of food all the way around Cider Hall. Being in the Reach, it's a very fertile region, meaning that there are fields everywhere. So we have barley, we have wheat, all kinds of crazy things around here, and I'm sure we're gonna see a lot of apple orchards and orchards in general, just to showcase the idea of Cider Hall. That's probably why they decided to call this place Cider Hall, is because of maybe when they first settled here there was an abundance of apples and things. Definitely a possibility. So there's a lot of makers and craftsmen and all kinds of things in this village in here, or this town per se. But yeah, that's pretty much the general idea. We've got some stables back here. I guess this is right behind the inn, so that would make sense. So maybe this is a place where travelers can put their horses when they are not traveling and spending the night at the inn. I'm sure that that's what that is there for. And then we got some things over here, like we've got a little bit more gardens. So this is actually a fairly large garden. We got a chicken coop back there. All kinds of crazy stuff. I always love just exploring through and seeing all the details around here. Lots of really neat things. One thing I want to show you, though, is this statue that's right out of front of the actual castle itself. As you can see, there is a statue of an archer right here. It's a really neat design. Really thought you guys might enjoy that. Some of the castles have these statues in front. It's kind of hard to see from anywhere except for this direction. But I'm sure there is some sort of lore based on that, but I am not sure what it is. So we are heading to the castle now. Like I said, this is on the Cockleswint, which leads to the Red Mountains. I'm pretty sure it's the Red Mountains that are along Dorne. So let's go ahead and knock on the door here. Looks like the door's open, so let's head on inside and see what there is to see. But yeah, this is the main courtyard.
Hey, you're there! You can't be here!
Oh boy. Oh boy.
Who the heck do you think you are?
Oh crap.
Just wait there. I'll show you some manners.
I don't think I should be here.
Just wait.
No. Leave me alone. No, I come in peace. I come in peace. No. Oh. Oh, ow. Ow, that hurt. Oh my goodness. Did you really have to throw me, man? Ow. Goodness. Why? Man, I'm so disappointed. You guys would have loved seeing inside that castle. There's so much neat stuff to see. It really is a pity. I can't believe that we can't explore in there. That's sad. So, unfortunately, that's the only crossing that I know of. So we're gonna have to swim across the river here to get to the other side. But I guess we're just gonna have to look at it from the outside, unfortunately, because, yeah. That looks like that guard isn't going to let us go inside and see what there is. So, anyways, I guess we'll be on our way. We're going to go down this way and continue the video. And, man, that was going to be a really good part of the video, too. I can't believe it. So we're going to keep going down this way. As you can see, we're passing more fields and everything leading up to the outside on the other side of the Cockleswint. This is now on the inner portion in between the Mander, which is over there. You'll see that boat, the sails to a boat over there, which is on the fork of the Mander and the Cockleswint right there. So right now we're heading down the road along this apple orchard, and this leads over to a guard's house and a few farmhouses down this way, which you can see just down the way. Now, I really like this guard post. This is a really neat design. I never really thought of doing things this way, but as you can see, this is built so that the only entrance to get in, like the only official entrance to get in, is from a ladder, which leads in up here, and it leads in right into here. So as you can see, there's like a couple beds in there, things like that sort, and then you come down, there's a little bit of a cellar down here, and a little fireplace, it seems. Wait, there's no chimney to the fireplace. That's a no-no. But yeah, then you come up here, and there's a little guard post where they can do their guarding, things like that. Actually, no, the entrance is right here. But I really like this design. I might actually try to replicate that for future builds, or for a future build. We'll see what happens. There's a well out here, things like that, and we got a couple farmhouses. We'll just go into one of them. As you can see, they have a little fireplace here in the corner. Ooh, there's grass in here. Not good. Grass in the bedroom. I bet that's not supposed to be there. But anyway, that's pretty neat. I really like this house. I really like their houses in general. Wester's Craft really does a fantastic job in adding in the immersion and details and everything. So really, really, really nice. So we're going to head back this way now. It looks like there's a farmer in the orchard right now doing a little bit of farming and grabbing some apples, it seems. Because this, I imagine, would be an absolute tedious job. Harvesting these apples. Let's go say hello, see what he's up to. Maybe he can tell us a few things. Where is he? There he is right there. Hey farmer, how you doing?
Oi, good day. You look like a strong apple, eh?
Try to be, yeah.
I could need some help with these apples, eh? What you saying? There's lots of apples around here.
I don't know if we have time for that
today. We've got red apples, we've got blue apples, we've got green apples. I could actually pay you with
blue apples before.
There's apples, apples, and apples. You know my old pa always said, the more apples, the better.
All right, have your apples. No, see you. No, leave me alone, please. Oh my goodness, man, that was scary. Now that was unexpected as well. I can't, things like that keep happening to us where people keep grabbing our attention, but, my goodness, it just happens, I guess. So we're going to keep heading this way and, find some more things to look at. So something I really wanted to show you guys is there's a tourney ground up here, and it's right in the middle of these orchards. I'm not sure if that really makes sense, but the concept is really cool. It really sets the idea that, again, Cider Hall in the middle of the apple orchards and everything, it really is pretty cool. So, yeah, I really like the idea in here. Oh, no. Oh, no. Not that guy, Cam. Please, not that guy.
Oh, hello there, Traveler.
Oh, boy.
Come closer.
Okay.
Hello there. How are you doing?
Good, I guess. What's up?
Beautiful day today, isn't it?
yeah, beautiful.
Please, come on around. Please, come on in, come
okay.
on in.
Okay.
Oh, by the way, have you seen the castle? You should totally see and check out the castle.
Wait, what?
It is
seriously?
Stunning.
You threw us out last time we were at the castle. That was...
Wait, what?
Yeah.
No.
What was up
with
that?
I'm sorry about that. That must have been my little brother, Bob. Yeah, he can be a bit of an asshole sometimes. I'm sorry about that.
Yeah, that was not very nice, I must say.
Well, if he makes trouble again, just tell him Mum made apple pie, okay?
Mum made apple pie.
He loves those.
Okay.
Yes.
I will be sure to tell him that next time. Thank you very much, sir. I really appreciate that. What was your name again?
Oh, I'm Dennis.
Dennis? Okay. Thank you,
yes.
Dennis. I appreciate that.
Your thing, mate.
All right, so that was really kind of him. All right, so now we will actually be able to see the castle. I am really excited now. But with that said, let's go ahead and check this this tourney ground out really quick and see what there is to see. So this here is a... I'm actually going to jump over there. So you can come up here. This is where the Lord of... I guess Lord Fossaway would sit up here. Lord and Lady Fossaway. And they would watch the tournaments. This is where they would joust and do some things like that. As you can see, these would be like the little spinny things, so like they would hit those. They could also take those away, because these are technically for practice. So maybe there's some practice going on over here. As you can see, the dentist is down there practicing with his sword, kind of just doing his thing. But yeah, I really like the colors of Westeros craft. Their wool is just very vibrant and it looks really nice. And so yeah, that's that. And I think we're going to head back down to Cider Hall now. Let's go ahead and just do a jump. Oh man, yeah. But yeah, anyways, so let's go ahead and head back down and see what there is to see.
Have a good one, mate.
Yeah, you too, sir. Thank you so much. Alrighty, so let's try this again. I really hope this password that Dennis gave us works, because I think it was like Mom Made Apple Pie or something like that. But I hope it works, because I don't feel like being thrown out again. So let's just go ahead and sneak in a little bit. Looks like the door's open again. So, let's just kind of sneak in here a little bit and see what's going on. I don't see Bob anywhere.
What? You again?
Oh, no. Oh, no.
Can't believe this.
What was it again? Apple pie. What? Mom made apple pie.
Oh, apple pie. I love apple pie. Mama, wait for me.
Okay. Interesting. So, that worked. That worked. I was not expecting it to work that effective. If we encounter any other guards, I guess we'll do the same thing. Maybe that'll be the same thing. But anyways, you come into the courtyard here, and you got an apple tree again. Again, sets the tone for Cider Hall, being that you cider's made from apples and such. And I really like the design of this courtyard. Over here, you have a few stables and such. As you can see in here, this is where there's several places for the horses to be. It's really simple, yet it's really effective, because you can get a lot of stables really compact in that space right there using that design. So this right here is the Great Hall. This is the feast hall where everyone would eat, drink, and do all that stuff. I really like the design in here, the bench and everything. It just looks really nice with all the food and everything. You got the fireplace here. With a chimney that, there's not much you can do with chimneys in general, but I love this ceiling pattern. Just that little bit of red really, really works well up there. It brings in the colors so nicely. And then, of course, these banners that are on the walls, that's a really, really cool idea. I'm really glad they did that. And I really like this sort of rafters where you sort of have these artistic bits that come down and around, as you can see. Really neat. And then you have the bus. It's kind of weird saying it plural, but as you can see, there's a bust right there. A bust of maybe it was a former lord. Maybe it's an armor stand for a really special armor or something like that. Just decoration. It really adds in a nice little atmosphere in here. And of course, we got the king's chair, the lord's chair. Lord Fossaway would sit here, and then his lady, and then probably his I would say probably his son or daughter would sit over there, I would imagine. But yeah, that's the idea with that, and the big old windows and everything. Just absolutely beautiful. I love the Westeros stained glass. Looks really cool. So anyways, let's keep walking through and see what else there is to see. So over here is where Bob originally threw us out. If we go out that door right here, looks like this is the audience chamber. This is where the Lord would actually see to the daily activities of what's going on around the castle. This is where he would tell everyone, hey guys, you know, you can do this, you can do that. I approve this, I approve that. That's where all this would happen. And probably he would pass that job to his chamberlain. His personal servant would probably be very trusted. And he would trust some of the dealings to his chamberlain, most likely. And then the big things, like all the big decisions, of course, the Lord would... for sure pay attention to. I would say this is probably a place where the council can be around a round table. I'd imagine that's what that is. And this is where Bob threw us out originally. But yeah, what a mean guy that Bob. But apparently he has a soft core, considering that he really likes apple pie. Last time I was here, I was doing a little bit of exploring before the video, and I got really, really lost. So I'm trying to keep my bearings, and I'm trying to stay pretty trying to stay where I'm supposed to go through this castle. So there are two sides to this castle, as you can see. Over there is the south side leading down towards Dorne, and then this is the north side that we're on right now, leading up towards the north, leading, of course, the north, but, you know, up that way is, like, Lannisport, King's Landing is up, like, actually that direction to the northeast, per se. So I'm trying to find a way to get out of here, so we're actually going to do a little parkouring down there, and I want to show you guys the kitchen underneath the feast hall. That's a pretty significant part of the castle, I would say. As you can see, there's a lot of food in here, all kinds of crazy things. I really like the fireplace. It's very large enough for the cauldron right here to do some food. You got some coal in there that honestly looks like lava, but a little baker's oven in there. Now, a lot of people think that the baker's oven has to have fire in it. It does not. The whole idea of a baker's oven, if it's, like, say if it's in a large fireplace like this, the stone in there would be extremely hot. Say if this fire has been going for a while, it would heat up inside the baker's oven, making it so that that would make the yeast and the bread rise. That's how they would usually cook bread and like that. So it doesn't have to have its own fire. It just would be heated up by the normal fire. So right here is the well. I imagine this would be pretty dirty water, though. I don't know, because there's a lot of garter robes leading down into the river here. But I really like this. This would also probably be a garbage chute where they would throw a bunch of the refuse and, like, compost they would probably throw into the river, things like that. Looks like that's what over here is. Wait, is it? Yeah, right here. What is this right here? I'm not even sure. This is probably a place. Oh, this is where they wash clothes. So that's a really cool detail. So this is like a place for the servants to wash clothes and things. Trying to hurry up. We don't want to spend too much time in here. So we have a cider press in here, one of those manual analog cider presses. So they'd probably fill this with apples and then they would crush that. And then they would take the shavings of the apples, and then that's what the shavings of apples. So this is the raw apples. They would crush it into that. But I'm not sure how they would get the juice out of that. Maybe this is actually already the pressed apples, and then they want to churn the actual apple skins into something. I'm sure there's some sort of utilization for that. And then, of course, you got a lot of cider being stored in here. So that is that. So I think what we're going to do now is cross over the river, over the Cuckleswint, leading into the other side of the castle. Now, what I'm trying to do is figure out how we're supposed to get up higher in the castle. Because honestly, I forget where the stairs are. Oh, one thing I want to show you before we do that is there is actually two prisons in here. There's one right here. This is like a group jail. This is a larger jail where people can do all kinds of crazy stuff, I guess. But yeah, that's like a more larger and more, like that's probably for more of a long-term jail sentence. And then in here would be something like a small jail for, like, oh no, maybe this is kennels. Oh, this is kennels. That's probably what this is. Yeah. This is kennels. I was thinking this is probably a prison as well, but then I just realized there's wicker there, and that's not going to really keep in a human. So anyways, yeah, that's that. So we're going to head over here. Got a little garden and some places for them to grow some fresh vegetables to feed the people here. A little place for some swine, aka pigs, would be there. And then we have a training yard over here. So, like, maybe a place where the captain of the guard can sit up here and watch. And then down here is where the guards would be practicing and preparing for battle if they so choose. One thing that I'm not really a fan of on this build is all these entrances leading out to the Cuckleswint. There's three that I've found so far. And it sort of lowers the defensive standard of the castle because there's all these entrances leading in. I feel like there should be less, but hey, it's not my build. I'm sure that they did it for a reason in any case. So I'm sure this is the barracks section that we're walking through right now, where all the soldiers and guards would be, would stay the night and do what they need to do. Right here is a bell. As you can see, the top of this building is more of like a Norman-style four-corner turret keep as the central keep, donjon of the build. And I really like that. As you can see, the top has all these little drains for the water to escape. That's a really cool idea there. And then we're going to head down the stairs here, which is going to lead to the king's bedroom somewhere in here. But I'm sure this is like, this is a royal family room right there. And here's the king's bedroom in here, I'm sure. Yeah, this looks like where the king would live in this room. He has all these bookshelves and everything like that. So I think that's really all we have time for. I really want to find the maester's, actually. If we can find the maester's room somewhere in here. Ah, this is where the maester would be in here, I think. Or no, it's not. I guess this would be the maester. I'm not even sure. I'm not sure where the rookery is. Usually these Game of Thrones castles have rookeries. Maybe we can find that at one of these top towers. Let's find it from the outside, because usually rookeries have big open windows where they would release the birds to go fly away and warn the kingdoms about things that are going on. Looks like another little dining room up there. I don't know where the rookery is, but I'm sure it's somewhere in the vicinity up here. So, anyways, guys, I hope you enjoyed this video. This was Cider Hall on the Westeros Craft server. If you guys want to work
here. Hey, Duncan, I'm here for the video. Sorry, man, I'm a little bit late.
Where have you been, man?
Man, I'm in such a great mood, man.
We're almost at the end, man.
I think this is gonna be awesome. I'd say let's just jump straight into the video. Oh man, this is gonna be awesome. So what you say?
I don't know about that, man. I think we're just now coming on the end. We're kind of running out of time.
Wait, you understand?
Yeah, we got in the video, sadly.
Let me tell you, I'm here. Well, you already did the video.
Yeah, what? We already did the video.
Wait, I thought you said 3 p.m.
We're going to have to catch you next time, though, man.
You meant GMT. I'm sorry, man. I messed up, man. Goodness. I'm sorry.
But yeah, we missed you, man. I'm sure that everyone's going to miss you in the video. But next time, right? Next time.
Yeah, next time I'll be on time. I promise, okay?
But anyways, guys, Victor Comics has a YouTube channel. You guys go check him out. If you liked his humor, go check him out in the description below. And go subscribe to him, because he has some fantastic content that you guys will enjoy. Minecraft content, comedy, real-life comedy, all kinds of crazy stuff. So, but yeah. Also, if you guys like what you see on this video, don't forget to hit that like button, comment below, and subscribe for more content. I'm definitely up for suggestions of other places you would like us to do walkthroughs for. So, yeah, for sure. Comment below and tell me what you want to see. I have a Twitch that you can watch me live stream and build. Also, I have a Facebook and a Twitter where you can follow me on. Same thing with Victor. All those links will be in the description below, guys. So, I hope you enjoyed the video. Until the next time. Say goodbye there, Victor.
Goodbye, everyone.
All right. Till then, bye-bye.